thanks. Some great tips, and we appreciate it. Sure. It's not that I'm like too experienced in life, but those are just some things that came to my mind. Actually, it's for sure the right feel. When my first turn here some days ago, it feels like I cash in every second one day and find table that as well already. Although I'm a cash player, lol. Yeah, I mean, naturally it's fucking great. Like, naturally it's like this side you want to add into your schedule if you want to grind it up. Because, like, it's soft, it's small feats, less variance, you get a lot of experience playing final tables. Like, it's just. It's such a good setting. Nice. Yeah, I hope they add some more tournaments, you know, if like you could, if you could grind a full schedule on the natural 8, it would be just so good. What the fuck? This seems like really weird to get it in there with 5-3. Let me see what happened there. How does he even have 5-3? Did he 3-bet him? What the fuck? What the fuck? This guy has like such a sick graph, but what the fuck? And he's out. Well played, dude. Well played. The fuck was that? Lol. No. All right, don't mind him doubling. Definitely a guy I want to keep around, you know? Nice turn. Alright, sorry for all the coughing, by the way, guys, but I figured it's still better not streaming at all, and it's just a bit too much coughing to mute the mic every time. So, yeah. Just gonna size up slightly here on the flop. Wasn't my usual small sizing, just because this board is like so wet and connected that I think it's much better to wrap stuff, and I also want a bit bigger. Easy call here with nines. Ooh, that's a wide jam. It's a pretty big pot actually. Nice hold. I coached by Dominic Nietzsche. Not like really coached, like he teaches me some things. Like, it's not that I have like a coach in you or something, we just hang out a lot, and every now and then he. We talk a bit about poker as well. Nice. Good flop. Good flop. Do-do-do-do-do. Dominic's coached by Bolero. I mean, I coach him in some aspects. This turn is interesting. That's not if you get many floats, yeah, we should just jam. Wow, that's so terrible. Oh my god. What's that terrible, man? I hate it when people are like terrible and then get lucky for it. It's just like regulars, that is. If it's fun player, it's fine. But like regulars are just playing so poorly, then it's just tilting. Ooh, nuts on the river. Actually, sank nuts. If he has sixes, we're gonna lose a big pot. Just snap rejamming. If he doesn't have an ace, he's not calling anyhow. Maybe he does. Let's take out him. Feels good, man. Nice river. I mean, he has no point double barreling ace 10 anyhow, but yeah, feels good. 2 out of 5. We made like almost $400 already. Achievement post something on Instagram. Guys, if you want to follow me on Insta, instagram.com/buildero. Really, really good place to follow. Keep my stories up to date, you know, like, because you saw a lot of stuff behind the scenes in Macau, you're gonna see a lot of more stuff in the future. Guys, we made our second final table of the day, already cashed for $600 in the $55 hyper, now the 44 PKO, second in chips, first place like $1,200. Let's get it. Nice. Social media, Lero. It's pretty small here on the flop. I think we have a clear call on the turn as well. I think really bending is too thin. It sucks if he bets here. But I think he would bet pocket eights on the turn quite often. Weird. God, that overcall with force, eh? Why, people, why? This could beat with the tens. Well, he bets flop, now bets really small on the turn. I just give him a raise. Pretty bad flop for tens. Over here, like, leading versus this is a limp pot. And he folds turn. Got him, boys. Got him. Folding tens. Turn goes check, check. Don't hate a quarter pot river bet here, just blocking. Oh, that's some clean value, guys. Did you see that? That's some clean value. Oh, getting called by ace high feels good. That feels good. Yeah, I should probably read through that here. Ooh, oh. I guess we bet. Queen is might be a pretty good hand to bluff with here. Oh shit. Alright. So we have ace king for some reason. That's a good turn. Ah, too bad. That's a fun turn. Oh, come on, Fnatic, do something. All right. 2-4. 4-2. Few jams, we have an easy call. I mean, a few jams, obviously. Would bet call here if he jams, even though I'm not excited about it, but imagine he would fold a lot here to this bet. Alright, but it's a good, good luck. Good round. Over here, bets flop, I call, now he jams turn, I get a call. It's not pre with him behind. That's a good chop for me, but like he jams 6, 7, 7, 8, you know, like I don't think I can fold there. Getting these odds. Rip. Can we fold the full house? Yeah, he stands clear fold there on the river. People are just not doing that. I mean, if he knows me, like with some random fish, it might be tough at times, but. Yeah, for me it's obvious. Wow. GG. He rejammed 17 blinds with an $81 bounty. We have a $15.95.50. It's a call. The chips are not worth as much as the bounty, so good luck. Oh, it's a great flip. Come on, King 10 check. King 10 check. Yeah! Come on! Flip Lero, flip Lero. But yeah, easy call. People do. Nice stuff. Common people. Man, his teeth feels like it feels so good. It feels so good. It's great. Like I thought, the longer I stream, the worse I would feel. But now it's actually the opposite. The longer I stream, the better I feel, and the better my throat is feeling. Life's good, guys. Life's good. It's nice to have a profitable session locked up as well. I really like the early start as well, to be honest. Like, I think we have slightly less viewers when I start this early, but it feels pretty good. Maybe I will try to keep it up for a while. I really just try to work on my fitness and mental game a lot lately. Yeah, let's just call. I mean, we're also running pretty good on this fine table so far. Thanks, Peter. Thanks for for setting up the payouts as well. Gonna check raise here. Come on, guys. Come on. Nice life we're living. Oh my god, he's 100 big blinds deep. I have all the chips and he's short. This is like, it's sick how quickly people busted here on the final table. I want the win. Mm. I like raising versus the sizing. I think people size up with two pair and sets here. I think at this point we have to bet river as well. I figured here on the turn he has like a lot of pairs with the straight draws, and I think a lot of them are folding on the river, like 8-7, 5-8, 5-4, 7-4. Maybe queen 8 even folds sometimes as well, but apparently not. Yeah, I feel like it's not that unreasonable to bluff there. I should be careful bluffing the fish here, obviously. But I figured it was a pretty decent spot to do so. I think I'm gonna start 3xing blind versus blind. Probably playing like a mixed strategy of raises and limps. Seems like that's what I want to do there. I'm in a nice position, like much better position than he is, because I can open quite wide given the big blind. And he can't open that wide given that I'm in the big blind. I always want to make sure like that the best player on the table, like if you open wide, you want to open wide when the good guy is in the small blind. I'll check here again. I think we could go for some river value potentially. I have such a weak king though. He still has like king 10, king 9. It's tough to get called here. But maybe we should try. Like throw in a little 4k. Why don't you play in the evening? The payouts are so much better. But it also means more runners, right? I mean, just you cannot just say like, oh, we should play in the evening. The payouts are bigger. Because that means there's also more players. So that doesn't make it more likely that you win a lot of money. Necessarily. Let's check it back here. I mean, 3x's it and attacks this board texture. He's pretty strong. An 8-4 of clubs, not a hand I want a triple barrel with. I think I'll just give this up. I have like so much like 7 deuce offsuit here, you know. Like, not quite, but 7 deuce of hearts or whatever. Love this jam, but the music is always so strange. Wow, am I just calling here? Nah, there's no way. I'm actually gonna check here. I think betting a third pot is also fine. But the problem is like if he ever jams the flop, it's just really bad for me. Let's just check it down. Maybe he has ace check. Nice, that's good, that's good. He had ace check, I guess. Ace check, yeah, definitely. As I said, gonna keep on being like fairly aggressive on the button. Like if he three bets me a lot, then maybe I will start like being a bit tighter. But it's just I can just call him with like so many hands. 100 big blinds deep. I'm probably like, I'm better post flop. I'm playing in position. Like, just gonna be tough for him to do too much. Nice T helped you throw it. Yeah, definitely. T is G T O. I live in Edinburgh, UK. Scotland. Oh, I go to the gym and get back. Blur's on the FT already. Let's go. Nice, Ollie. Let's get it. So this guy is a bit over it. Just champs like 50 blinds on a button. Ugh, this is filthy. Filthy. Whew. That's a filthy flop. I mean it in a good way. I think that's the 3-bet I'm just folding here. I hate my life, though. At least we're doing pretty good against the checks. Small bet here. Let's hope we get raised. Nope. Oh, two calls, though. Two calls. Yeah, we're definitely going for three streets here. I mean, you can have ace to zero, but it's only one combination, so. And pocket threes and pocket nines, obviously, but yeah. He might raise those on the flop as well. At least pocket nines, not pocket threes, I guess. Size it up on the turn. Yeah. The thing is, like, he doesn't have that many 9x because it's like 9, 10 of diamonds or whatever. Like, 9x of diamonds. So it's just not that many combinations with, like, 3x and maybe other hero calls. But I guess he still folds a lot. But then he was, like, calling station earlier, so I think we still jam here for value. Yeah, that's pretty nice. Like, with the flush for picking, I think he's. And he's, like, a bit of a station, so. It's pretty good. Full payout there. Full payout. Now we're playing an insanely deep heads-up match. It's like. 150 B deep average. Alright, let's see. Thing is, like, we can't even chop it because it's like a PKO, right? I think we should bluff here. This is like so low in my range. That makes sense. Someone who plays recreation stuff the field is better for my bank, but it's not as much as fun, to be honest. Yeah, makes sense. Not even a tide right now. Thought about leaning here for a second, but I don't think we should. It's just limp. Yeah, I will probably start grinding the evening when I'm in New Zealand. I will see. Like, at first I think I will try playing in the evening. And if I don't like that, I might just come back and, like, play at a different time of the day. But I will play the European evening, like the big tournaments. At the start, at least. I feel pretty confident, honestly, in this heads-up match. I open this, he regens 40 blinds. An easy call. Holy fuck. That's another bounty in that one. What's up with people punting like that today? Crazy. Easy continue. I think there's also a turn call. I don't know, because he also has a limping range, which gives him, like, probably fewer bluffs here. And he also sized up on the flop. I'm actually going for a tight lay down. Maybe shouldn't talk that much. He's probably watching the stream. Wow, that is just so bad. He can't lose to 8-5 there. Yeah, that is, like, that is bad. Holy shit. So you can just decide not to bluff there, you know? Yeah, that's definitely like a really, really bad check down with 7-5 off. I mean, he just says I'm not bluffing that spot, and it's such a good round for him to bluff. He's saying that he doesn't have two pair, he doesn't have king x. He has a few king x, but not enough not to value bet my check deuce, given that I expect him to lead most of his jack x to beat me. Yeah, that's a good value bet. That's a good value bet right there, guys. That's what I'm fucking talking about. Let's go. He has ace 8 and makes a call. Feels good, man. Feels good, man. That was a nice value bet. Nice two streets with check deuce there. That's clean. Just gonna open jam here so often. I feel it. I can smell the open jam. Yep, there it is. Oh, I smelled that. Nice call, Briefflop. Nice call, dude. Whoa! Alright, we're all in here with our nut flush drawer. What? What are people throwing me with here? Sick. No respect. No respect for the kid. Give him the good old race with the king 5. And now we're gonna check out the turn. Yeah, I think we just gotta check it here. Just take the showdown value. 7s, alright. Yeah, I'm in Scotland. How did I go? Just study. Like, get every stud resource you can and study, study, study. Given the speed he called, the bet, I like a small bet here. You can't chop Pico, you can't chop the bounty. But yeah, it just comes down to study, study, study. That's how I got to my level. I'm just yesterday, for example, like I couldn't play because we had that UK issue that I need to figure out. And then I just studied for like 5 hours. Played 2 hours of cash game, not to make money. I mean, I won a bit of money. But just to study cash game and play deeper stack poker and stuff like that. So, like a lot of stuff I do is just to improve the game. Improve my game. I think it's fine to like 3-bet this sometimes. That's a pretty good flop. Yeah, I think we can start with the bet here. He doesn't have sets. He has some ace-x here. Ace-check, ace-queen probably. Maybe him 4-bets those. I think we should check here. I don't like giving him free equity with his 2 pairs though. That's like the only thing I don't like. But then he only has like 8%. Do we think he's value betting a 9 if I check it here? I mean, I think we should just bet 2/3, make sure we get caught by an ace X. But he probably bets on the turn. It depends on the guy. Kind of an interesting spot. Nice. Some good value, guys. Some good value. He had 8-9, makes a call. Clean stuff, clean stuff. Nice runner for me. He calls 8-9 off there. Is he just a fish? He probably just is a fish. Like, how do you call my 3 with 8-9 off? I made it 4x. Do you think that's profitable? What's his name? Fong? Oh, yeah, he's definitely a fish. He just put on a lot of volume. Queen high should just be good at showdown often enough. Nice. But this is what I mean, like, it looks like we're absolutely owning him, and I think we're playing good poker, but pretty favorable runouts as well. Yeah, like, he's definitely fish. I don't think I should fold here with that sizing. I'm in position versus size and we just shouldn't fold much. He sizes up his raise sizing a bit now. Now he should raise his limbs more, but like he's pretty sticky in general. Yo, what's up, Path? Thanks for the 500 viewer host. Baby, less than a month and we live together. Alright, let's go. I'm ready. Let's play some heads up. Are you leaving Edinburgh? No. I'm gonna keep my apartment while I'm in New Zealand. Oh, thanks God. Thank God. I would have had hated my life if it's real there because like we should obviously call our hand, but not with him. Yeah, but I'm not leaving Edinburgh. I'm just like in New Zealand for like those 6 months and then I'm getting back to my apartment, living my life here. So I'm just gonna improve his hand sometimes, but not often enough to not very bet it myself. The king is pretty good for him, given the speed he called on the turn. I think like check calling is the play now. Because he has like some pretty natural bluffs usually. And sometimes he turns that into a bluff as well. How much did you lose in Macau? I won like 10 to 15k. Finally we can raise this limp. Made it fairly large because I don't think he folds much. This is a pretty good flop for his limping range, so I'm gonna start with the check. Can check raise or check call. I think we check call. Like, we just outplay him post so much that I think it's best. Actually, we should lead turn here. The ace is a much better card for me than for him. So I think, like, starting some leads is fine here. Alright, so he has a better hand right now than me, that's for sure. But given that I can improve my hand on the river, we call. Diamond. Nope. Hurts. Hurts. Can you retire now on the 100k? No. Also, retiring is not about can, but it's about if you want to retire, and I'm far away from retiring from poker. I'm having way too much fun. Playing like $3, $10 years ago, or two. I'm pretty clear value bet. I think we should just open any two on the button and against him now. He threw at me once so far. And just generally, like, he raised before on a board like this. I think he definitely does it a bit too wide, I would assume. But like with A3, we just don't really have any follow-up, so betting seems like the line. Lose a flip over here. Or 60-40. Yo, thanks, Nico. Maybe you have to be careful, like, that I do not defend the big blind too wide, given that he has a limping range as well. It makes us, like, when some people have a limping and a raising range, their raising range usually becomes a bit stronger. I think that's certainly a case for him. It's a good hand to check raise sometimes, but I think when he sizes it up slightly, I give him a bit more value in the spot. Sadly, can't play that trade in the UK yet. Flip over here. This time looks better for us. Nice. he doesn't fold to 3-bet, so I don't think I'm on the 3-bet bluff very much. I just want to keep the pot small with, like, these hands. Usually have a 3-bet here, like, sometimes. But with him, I think call is just better. I mean, we're never folding here. We could raise sometimes, but I think we want to call mostly. I might, I don't know. I'm not sure if I play it. We'll see about that in the future. Alright, second time he 3-bets me. We'll still assume he only does it with, like, strong value. So yeah, I think for him definitely the line is, like, just to play with many checks. Like, preflop just doesn't make much sense to raise this ISM a lot. I like a bluff here. Nice hero, damn. Got us, boys. Yo, Aussie Poker Boss with a 10x3 set. Welcome back home, dude. Thank you. Alright, he found the 3-bet button now. Let's call. And flop 6. Not quite. Let's go mate GLGL today. Thanks, man. Welcome back home. Yeah, it's not pretty. I think I should call once. Turn should slow him down sometimes. It's good. I think we want to block bet. I think we just want to get the showdown here. So check it back and see about the river. Wow. Nice value, brother. I think a 9 off is too good not to raise here. Oh, he didn't fold one. Let's keep that in mind. But this is just what I mean. Like, you see that swing again in his favor? That was just because he hit, like, a couple of flops. It's always, like, how it works pretty much heads up. Maybe also, like, the 2 times he raised me on, like, these low, low boards, he may just had it, you know? I think it's bottom pair here quite often. Yeah, it's a great spot to bluff. I just don't think he has many kings in his limping range, so he's gonna have a lot of like 6x and stuff like that. So later on, it's too poor to bluff. So I'm getting locked up way too often here by 6. Oh, we actually good. So he had like 10-8. Yeah, he had 10-3. It's nice. But yeah, that fits in with the read I have on him. It's a pretty good flop. I'm gonna size it up. Maybe not that much. Is the race coming? Nope. Nah, the 8 is sadly not like an ideal turn, but I don't think he would ever check race bluff me on the turn, so I'm just gonna bet again. I almost want to value bet the river here, to be honest. As I said, like, I think he's just going to check raise a bunch of, like, 2 pairs in the turn, maybe straights. I don't know. He could have, like, queen 9, but, like, he probably just folds on the flop. Yeah, he should value bet. He's also a bit of a station, obviously. All right. Still fine, 2 streets. Feels pretty good. If you want to learn how which poker sets you can play from Australia, just go to, like, twitch.tv/allinpair. He has, like, some in the description. And then you can click those links and figure it out. Go for a 3-wood here with King Jack suited. He's just going to continue with a lot of hands we dominate. That's a good start. I mean, if he has ace-check, we go broke here with 3 seduces. It's okay. I'm going to size up slightly versus him. But he just has so many weaker check-x that we should always go for 3 here. I mean, he has a couple of 3x, but just not that many. So I think I'm still just going for all of it. All right. And we're on to tee number 4. A tee break, guys. Let's just go. Oh, yes. Yeah, I'm still gonna play those. Like, your RI is way too high in these smaller buy-ins. Not that the 20% rake increase actually affects you, or affects your RI significantly. I still hate the rake changes. Like, that's always about protecting the fun players and recreationals, but with that change, they primarily hurt those. So it's just like the first, or like it's another big step in the direction of making the games unbeatable, which is obviously quite sad to see, and there's just not much we can do about it, right? But it's important to point it out at times. It's a pretty bad turn. I think we're still very bad though. Maybe checking is better. Nah. If we had like an ace deuce here or whatever, we'll check, but a6 is just a bit too good. I think I also very bad this river. So yeah, it's easy for him to have 3x, but it's easy for him to have other stuff as well. And he likes calling. Nice. Good 3 streets of value. He had ace 8. Nice stuff. He raises up, I think, for 45 blinds. We just want a 3-bet. It just kind of sucks if he jams it here, but it shouldn't happen that often. Yeah. C-bet. Interesting turn. Let's check. That's pretty filthy. I think I'm gonna call this once, even though the check flop sucks. 44,000 left. Oh, this is so fucking disgusting. I hate this river. This is a really bad river. Alright, he just did a7 off. Yeah, he just likes calling 3-bets, man. Damn, sucks that he outflops me there. Maybe he should full turn, but like with all the gut shots there, I think it's fine. We haven't seen much, like, we checked it down earlier with the... Actually, yeah, I think we should still call overall. He just likes floating a lot as well, yeah. So, it's a good call, nice. I think the rake increase has already happened. Could be wrong though. Yeah, maybe surfing is the end, we'll see. Actually, I feel like 4-9 connects a bit too well to bet the flop here. Because he does like these re-raises on these board textures, and if I can't recall them, it sucks. Just gonna give up again here. Let's hope he has 8-6. 6-9. That's pretty sick. That's pretty funny. It's like, how did I win there? It's weird that he doesn't eat those hands sometimes. Like, Might make the ace check just a turn fold. But then again, he likes floating so much that I don't really like the turn fold. We have quite a big edge here, I would say. It's just nice stuff to close out these SR matches. Should be a fairly good board for him. I think we're gonna we'll delay bluff this one. Yeah, I think I'd call here. Not ideal, but we can bluff like every spade. It's like we have quite some good bluff spots on the river here. And obviously if 7 queen or check could give me easily the best hand. But yeah, maybe you should only call with the spade as well. I think we're just gonna call a lot of hands. Like, even though he hasn't limped in a while, but I don't know, I just think we should have enough of an edge post flop to make like queen three a profitable call here. Not sure. There's a third pot I call there. Do do do. Yo, Gilden with the 90-month resub. Welcome back home, dude. Welcome back home. Thank you, man. Let's go. Alright, I'm gonna size up a bit here. Actually, I like an overbet. But then again, he's pretty sticky with his draw, so I guess we want to make 12k. If he wasn't as sticky with his draw, so I'd like an overbet there. Yeah. Thank you, dude, man. 19 months. Sick shit. How's Macau? Great. Lots of fun. Didn't run as good as I could have, like bubble 3 events and shit, but with that 1/3 place finish for 27,000, I netted some nice profit. Alright. I guess you check this back with a small blind flatting range. We don't block king jack, we don't block king queen. But I don't think we had much value on the river. Just betting the flop here to deny some equity. Yeah, I pricked a lot, but the 1D Brown made up for it. I think we showed the 3 better hand, like check 10 suited. Against calling range, which is doing too good. I'm not that happy about the tank, though. Tank open, though. Let's bet the flop. Nice. Come on, it's getting down to under 100k again. Just nice when you get the fold on the flop, you know. You don't have to worry about other shit. Just get the fold. It's a good life. Nice. Some more value. He had ace 4, that's a good river. First 3 bet jam, guys. He's down to 40 blinds. I don't think he's gonna limp any ace X, so I like a bet here. Like, so far, we've only seen him raise ace-x, so I think I can safely value bet there. Like, I think the ace is perceived to be good for his range, but it actually is just not, given his limping range. Alright, let's fire a flop bet here. Every time I did this bet, he folded so far. So maybe he is the type of guy that only, like, raises value. Just give him up at the check to 3. Not really a hand you want to bluff with here. I mean, I played poker as a kid a couple of times, but like playing it professionally and trying to make like my work my way up has been for a bit over 2 years now. Oh, 3-bet is coming. Nope. Let me come home. Home is whenever I'm with you. JFB with the 10 months. Thank you, dude. Welcome back home. Cheers. Let's get that guy, guys. I want to win it. Nice little 44 Pico win, you know? Too many outs. Yeah, we can bet here. It's the gut shot. That raise is just too big to call with the gut shot. I would call smaller raises, but with the sizing like that, we just call nuts. We just call the nuts. Maybe I could. No, he has better 8x, yeah. If he had a stronger 8x, I wouldn't mind leading. I think it's fine to go for two streets here. Let's get this guy. Like, it's fairly, like, obviously the tournament is not that huge, but he sets up matches are always important. Like, I have a $170 bounty, and, like, his bounty, and then my own bounty. Makes for, like, quite an important heads-up match here. It's a good river. I'm gonna use a pretty big sizing here. I actually want to make sure we call some 9, so let's just go with 16k. Nice. At first, I thought I would want to overbet. He had King Jack, yeah, that sucks. Like, that hand is calling an overbet, but I think with, given all his 9x in that spot, and we expect him to bet it check X sometimes himself, I think we just want to bet smaller. Please don't jam. Yeah, that's pretty sick. Wow. I think I'm just gonna fold this. We have such a huge edge post-flop that I don't want to get an ace 10 here for 40 blinds. It's fucking brutal because he could be rejam like an ace 5, but I'm just not sure if he would, honestly. I'm not sure at this point, and I feel like giving him that double up is just not worth it. I have to be maybe more careful now and like raise less or maybe limp more and stuff, but if he does it more often. Yeah. Just take my showdown value here. He doesn't like bluffing. He had deuce four off, you know, just checks it down. Yeah, it's interesting. I think the fold with ace 10 is pretty good, actually. We want to take it as low variance as possible. Seems like a good hand to bet turn with. Just fold in that case. Once again, he doesn't have ASEC, so we can just bluff here. Seems like so unlogical to bluff these ASECs, and it kind of feels bad, but like it's just so obvious what his limping range looks like, so that's abusing for him for that. Let me come home. Home is when. Oh. Sucks so hard, man. But I'm so sure like these folds are just correct. 19 month again. Come on, Twitch. We back. Cheer, Henry. Less than 3. Less than 3. Bigger than 19. Welcome back home, mate. Welcome back home. Thank you for the 19 month. Thank you. I think we get locked up too often here. Yeah, I think that's calling too often on the river. I'm pretty sure. Welcome back home, Ace of Base. Sorry guys, it's tough to focus with like the heads up match and like having to fold some shit. I mean, I played poker when I was like 10 years old with friends, but, like doing this whole thing or like playing this poker professionally and trying to work my way up was when I was 19. New hairstyle, yeah. Got that fresh cut going. But that's what I mean, like, we've made two big folds and we've only won, like, 20,000-30,000, like, that's 10 big blinds. Given, like, all the little pots that I can pick up, it just seems really not worth it. Thanks, Imoka. I'm 21. Yes, I'm 21. This call doesn't feel good, but I think we should do it. Nice. He had a 7. Lucky river, Henry. Alright, if you rejam here, we have a call. Finally. I just got a very bet against him. It's not pretty. Yeah, let's go, guys. Down to 50k now. He had 8-4. Who hit 8-4 and didn't jam turn and got punished by the river? Let's go. It's actually a good turn call, but just really didn't expect him to, like, not rejam 2 pair on the turn there. Nice, what a kind message. Good luck, dude. Good luck. Yeah, we're gonna keep on raising. Maybe size it down a bit now. We almost have him, guys. Slow and steady, no low variance. Low variance poker. Call off is 10. It's definitely a really, really tight fold, and it's definitely exploitable. But nobody's gonna exploit me for it. Like, if he was a regular or whatever, like, I would call ace 10 because we're flipping there every time. But just for him, it's not necessary. It's just a bad call. Like, variance needs to be as low as possible. Yeah. I don't think I can. I would value better 3 or 4. I don't think I should value better 6 because of that reason. Nice. Let's go. That's the exact reason right there. I'm gonna still open like really, really wide, and if he starts rejamming more as it looked like, then I'll just shut it down a bit. For 20 blinds, we're going with the ace 8. And we're gonna raise call the king queen as well. I actually like a check back here. Like, if you check jams this flop, it kind of hurts with king queen. So I want to see bet like a weaker hand, kind of. Yeah, I think we should call. Because he doesn't follow through on his bluffs on the river ever, so we can just try to get there. What did you tell the barb? What did you ask for? Is that 4 millimeters on the side and a bit longer so I can put some backs in and put it up. Thanks, Pav. This feels a bit thin, but I think it's fine with swim. Ooh, what a river. Over Betlero. Same head, Danny, with the Twitch Prime stuff. Thank you, dude, and thanks, Pat, for the support. Welcome home, man. I'm gonna limp this because if it rejams, it just sucks so hard for my hand. So I wanna open a little more polar. I like a float here. He could fold the king ten pre-flop. Like, the only time he 3-bets me was, like, really, really tight, but I limped it, so I'm not sure how tight his raising range is. Crying me down. I think he's just gonna raise a lot of like his queen 10 type hands, 9 10 type of hands, giving him more like just bullshit in these spots. So I think c-betting a7 is actually fine versus that limping range. Yeah, I think we just gotta fold now. Yes, definitely. Like the micros, it's totally fine still. Like your ROIs in these tournaments are just so high that like a 20% increase in rake doesn't really affect you. Thanks, Yannick. So let's say like the rake is like overall, it's like an extra 2% of the buy-in over there. So instead of making like having a 30% ROI, you're gonna have a 28% ROI, right? It's not that big. Look at this. Oh. I was like, he can't have the ace, so what is he repping? And then like he just checked it down three times with that hand. Got me. Oh, we get 3-bet, the sizing's too small. See flop, guys. Hearts. Hearts. It's when the flip versus kings here. Actually, we're favorite against kings, right? No. Slight favorite. Good luck. All right. It's 8. Foo. Big pot. Yeah, easy float. Nice. Grind him down once again. I'm back in my place in Edinburgh for the next couple of weeks. Fucking ace deuce, man. Painful stuff. Such a long heads up match, man. Just as I thought we had him. Just as I thought it would all be over. That's a turn. That's such a sick river. That is such a sick river. As long as he doesn't have 9-6 or some shit. I mean, he's never folding an 8, is he? Is he ever raising us with an 8? I don't think so. He might, actually. So what are we targeting for value? A 7 or an 8? If I bet small, he raises an 8, right? Yeah, let's bet small and get the raise from the 8. If he just called an 8, I'm gonna lose my shit. Don't... Here, 10-7. Alright, all good. I don't know, I think we can do two things, like overbet and just get called by the 8, or like just bet small and induce the raise. Good pot though, good pot. Let's call again. I hope he doesn't bet turn here. I feel like he's really, really value heavy if he does. Yeah, it's disgusting. I'm gonna go for the tight later on. I think that's the right fold against him once again. Like, he just hasn't barreled much. He likes to c-bet maybe sometimes and then just gives up every time pretty much. So it's just not profitable to call there. Once again, small 3-bet. He's going to have a strong hand, but we just priced into call. All right. Another question is, often would he check a better ace on the flop here? Not sure. Let's call and hit a 6 on the turn and then just jam and stack ace king. Is he ever like double barreling checks here or whatever? Seems pretty unlikely. I think we want to bet small here and just check back the river. I'm pretty sure we had now when he checks the turn. That's good. Getting him down there again. Ooh, big bet like that. I think that's just value every time, so I'm going for a tight laydown. Think we make like some pretty good folds and plays against him. He likes 3-betting more now, man. Hey, maybe he just picked up a couple of hands, most likely. Chop it up. The grind, boys, the grind. Actually, we should lead here. Should get infinite folds given this raising range versus limping range. Guess we just have to give up. I would bluff like a 5 or 3 river here. Yeah, and so he has like 7-5 himself or some shit. Ace 8, okay. Yeah, seems fine. Like, we have so many good turns to barrel again there. Just 6 is just not one of them, right? So, I like it. So, he has a weaker queen and just rejams. No. It's gonna be 3-bet. Gonna make it fairly big. Like, he likes calling these 3-bets. So, I wanna charge him while we're ahead. With pocket hands, there's like quite a few boards where you can only get like a street or two of value. But we've almost got him under 100k again. He likes 3-betting more now. Maybe he's not as polarized as he was in the past. I will call the flop here. Just give me a check. It's tough to fold these hands, man. He 3-bets a lot now. As I could literally just be him picking up hands. Alright, let's give me that straight turn, baby. Give me that straight on the turn. So I feel like this is not as value heavy. We should just raise. But then again, like we have too strong of a hand. If I had a hand weaker than this, I would raise. Let's go up. It's a bit over 50 bigs now. I'm gonna block better river here. He's not bluffing there. Bad run out. We definitely had the best hand on the turn there. Let's really block bet the river. Otherwise, I have to check and then call a bigger bet. I like raising here. Just has garbage every time and he limbs, so. I'm gonna punish him a bit for it. I kind of want to bet the turn here again, because if I check, he can just, like, step everything. It's really tough for me to call. But he has so many floats that we just see enough folds here, I think, on the turn. Wow, that's so sick. That's what I mean, like, a couple of hands where he flops it, and things are just looking pretty poor. Easy raise call over here. It's a pretty important pot. Ah, sad to be flipping. Hold. Nice. Yeah, just gotta keep calm. Over 200k for him now. Back to even. I'm not sure if we ever were even before. Yeah, we don't have to double bear the queen 5. I just thought, like, with all the floats he usually goes for, it seems fine. It's time to pick up like a decent hand as well. It's been a while. It's a bad river. I think it's fine to value bet there. I wouldn't value bet any like weaker check there if I have it or any 10. Ugh, come on. This is what I mean, like in heads up, you can so easily go like south, even though you don't really do much different. I mean, besides like the queen 5 spot, I would say. We just need to flop something first and then get 3 streets, as we usually do. Do we want to bluff the king? I don't think so. These turns are so sick, like, just give me something to work with, you know? Not like the fucking worst turn in the deck. Alright, let's hope we win here on the river. Nope, just call king queen. That's what I mean, like, if the turn is like any low card, we can just bet again and get the fold there. Fucking frustrating. Call. Going for my classic bluff on the Ace River. Good call by Jack High. He finally got us, guys. He finally got us. Sick, getting wrecked right now. Alright, this is the spot. Let's get three streets, okay? Three streets for the boys. Three streets for the boys. So he doesn't have 3-4 or some shit like that. Nice. It's so sick. We just need to flop something versus him. And then, like, he pays us out every time. He had 5-2. Oh, my God. Let's flop some things again, okay? A couple of times now, and then all good. He regens 8 blinds. We get a call off. 40% Lero. Ugh. Rip Lero. Nice. Good, good, good. Win another pot here. So let's flop like a good hand again a couple of times and just get all the value. Make the switch in your head to playing from behind before your slippers slope it. What, mate? Just like the advice I'm getting, come on. I have to be careful. He has been 3-betting quite a bit now, so we might get to the point where I just need to stop opening less on the button. But all of these opens that I assume to be profitable are just losing. It's like such a station, you know, we just need to flop it again and then go for like three streets. Maybe we should use some bigger sizings as well. We open kings, big blind defense, let's go for a third pot bet. Just get the fold. Was this a limp pot? No, it wasn't. In a limp pot, I would like just bet two streets for value. Nice. Yeah, I think it's time to stop bluffing. Besides C bets, he caught with the pocket fives. Gonna fold this. And good luck with the queens, guys. Pretty sick pot. Open, three bet, jam, overcall with the biggest bounty. So easy queens. All right, let's hold. That is an important hold right there, ladies and gentlemen. 40k, $45 bounty, biggest bounty in the tournament. Let's go. Over here, open, flopped, goes check, check, and now I'm firing and get the fold. We're about to cash the big 11 as well with starting stack. All right, got to call a 3-bet here. Come on, give me a good flop. Some potential here, I would say. This is so filthy. We got to call with the backdoor flush. Let's just hit the 10 and make this. Like, it's over when I hit the 10 here. God. I'm going to check here. Actually, the chance that he check jams the turn is... It's not zero. Okay, so I guess I check it back. All right, now we just check it back. Let's go. Come on. Come on. Milko with the 2-year resub. Sicko. Sicko. Welcome back home, dude. Thank you very much. I'm not gonna bluff you again. I'm just done bluffing. Thanks a lot, mate. Welcome back home. Let's get this fucking win, guys. Come on, it's incredible. Who's this new streamer? We have to be careful. Maybe defend the big blind a cup too wide as well, but it's always tough to say that when you just don't flop shit. He threw bet a7 off, right? So I guess we're gonna call now? I mean, sizing is just a bit too big, I guess, but yeah, definitely have to keep that in mind. Like, he's getting a bit out of line with the 3-bet, so it might be time to mix in some 4-bets. Right, he had a7, that was my queen check, pretty sure. Was a7 suited or offsuit? Let's see. A7 offsuit, yeah. Like, he's getting out of line with the 3-bets, guys. And it also means if he 3-bets a7 off, his range is gonna be pretty weak on a6 boards. I think we can bet here. Just more for protection when he has that many like low cards in his range. And obviously his turn rolls off. We just give up. Hope he has some missed flush draw. Nope, it's just a top pair. This sucks. This sucks really bad. That's ace queen for 20 blinds, so good luck. Potential slow roll. Shows a 10 and folds. Pretty weird spot, the 3-bet fold for that sizing as well. How thin is the value bet here with 6? Too thin. Actually, we chop it. No, we don't. We chop it. Yeah, if I check 6 or 10-6, I would value bet. Yeah, sorry guys, it's pretty tough for me to read chat while I'm playing this sets up match. Ooh. First time a good hand here. A really good hand, that is. Waited for one like this for a while. So he goes a bit wild here. He likes floating, so I guess I'm still betting a quarter pot here, even though my hand can't... Actually, aces wants to check. I would quarter pot, like, any pocket pair here besides aces. Alright, I think we're just checking again. The problem is, like, we block his calling range with aces, you know. And now the spot is pretty funny, because he might think we're also just playing the board, so I'm just gonna pot it and hope he calls for the chop. Actually, I will go with like 32k because he's definitely calling this every time. And maybe going bigger is a bit too greedy. This is nice. Like, if I bet pot, he might still call, but maybe not always. And I want to make sure he always calls. He had king 8 off, by the way. Like, he's so out of line. Yeah, I think it's important to get the guaranteed call there with that sizing. I mean, he's a bit of a station, so maybe it's a bit too nitty as well. I think we check here. It's a good runout. Wow. Let's fucking go, man. Bets the 7. Bets the 7 for that sizing. What is he doing? why always a fucking 6 on the river? Nice, we still win because he doesn't bluff like the best fucking card to bluff there. He had 4-10. He just checked down 4-10, man. This guy's so crazy. It's insane. Like, what the fuck is this? Oh, he had 4-10 of spades. Holy shit. That is pretty absurd, by the way. Just as a casual 4-10 of spades, you know, like... Could have been fun. I mean, he had a flush draw, but just saying. Like, if the spade hits, it's all over. Alright, so we've been playing heads up for an hour. And it's break now. Alright, let's finish this heads up. He has 25 blinds. Hopefully he took like a long break. Nope. See, I'm gonna... Maybe should be a bit tighter. At least with the defense. I think the opens are just fine because he folds a lot to my c-bets. I think it's big enough a station to value bet this. Nice. Nice, 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 nice. He called queen six. Great. Let's raise him. Come on, guys. Let's fucking finish this heads-up match. 66,000. Let's get it. I'm gonna limp here. Could also just open jam, but once again, variance low seems like a good thing. Or to lower the variance, that is. Gonna stab the flop here. He's just gonna have a lot of like random shit that has to fold like 10 deuce off, 7 deuce off, 7 3 off, 7 4 off. Which is cool with us because it's actually ahead of my hand right now. I went to work, came back, and then he still heads up. Yeah, I fixed the mic muted early enough. It's just a fold versus him. Easy call versus, like, easy chippy V call, but versus him, we just shouldn't call these spots, I'm so certain. A6 off is pretty close, like, it's a pretty tight fold. But I feel like, just, like, raising, betting small on these flops, and then getting a fold most of the times is just too good. I know I'm, like, really tight with these call-offs, but I just... I want to keep the variance so low, like, it's so nice, like, he always calls us down, we just need to hit something, you know, and then we get, like, then we just stack him at some point anyhow. I'm gonna call turn here if he bets, hopefully he doesn't bet too big, unlike this tank. He had 9-7. He had 4-6, never mind. This guy. What's the solution? I still have to ask how much refund I got. I got a refund, but I don't know for how much money. No. This is just going to be a limp. These are just read the hands I don't want to raise forward. I don't think I want to bet the flop here versus his checking range. Like, his checking range should do pretty good here. Alright, and now we're just going to overbet turn. He's going to have lots of single pair hands, so I'm just going to overbet versus station. Hope he didn't fold something big there. Maybe he realizes I'm only overbetting for value. Could be it. Or not. This could be it. We call the 4-bet jam. It's a bit aggressive. Let's hold. Nice. I think we kind of just bet the flop here. And this time we call, good luck. Alright, we own 2 and flips heads up so far. Expect 150k. Let's keep on grinding, guys. It's a limp pot, right? Yeah, we should definitely bet twice. Yeah. Maybe I shouldn't bluff. He's such an incredible station. I just shouldn't bluff, man. I tell myself every day, like every time. And then there's like these good spots. He does three off, man. We actually had on the turn. It's so sick. This fucking dude. I should have bet the flop here, by the way. I mean, I can still just bet the turn here. That's pretty nice. Should get like so many folds on the turn here. Yeah. Gotta raise, I guess, more of his limbs. Like, when he limbs 2-3 off, man, I just can't let him get away with that shit, you know? Especially when he never limp re-raises. Good luck for my last three blinds. Rip. I accidentally thought I open raised, but he limped and then I raised over it. Raise call on the nines here. That's gonna flip. It's a good start. Stars nuts, let's go. Oh, dude. And the replay, you can see his hands. And he doesn't show. How does he fold? He found the fold button, guys. Limp cards every time until you get kings, yeah. Don't think I can value better shitty 9. Look at his flop sizing as well. So sick. Come on, king on the turn. I think he only check raises flush draws, to be honest. I'm gonna bet the turn here, just for protection. Charges flush draws. Wow, this is so fucking sick. I mean, he's rejamming, right? Yeah. I mean, if he has it here, good for him. You know, if he has a better 8 or if he has a boat, good for him. But it just seems unlikely that he checks 2 pair on the turn. Alright, seems like we have the best hand, at least. Alright, he was just bluffing. That's a good pot, he's down to 40k, guys. 10 big blinds, alright, we almost have the heads up. Holy shit, finally. What an insane heads up match. What an absolutely insane heads up match. Is this... Oh my god, how does he wake up with this? King! King! Jack, come on, top. Oh god. Make it fucking stop. Just fold the flop, mate. Just fold the fucking flop for once. Yeah! Come on. There's just some spots that are good to bluff, you know? Like, it hurts my body too much not to bluff in certain spots. Ooh, this could be fun. Boatlero, boys. Alright, you're gonna hero call the shit out of me, mate, okay? You can do that? Ja, thank you. Ja, Mann. Hier King Deuce, what a river. Alright, let's go. Nope. Less than 10 big blinds for him, guys. Is it finally over? Is it finally over? After losing two flips and heads up. He has the 10 here. Alright, let's hold. No 5. No diamond. Ja! Ja, Mann! Give me some Yamans in the chat. We finally take the tournament down. Holy shit, that was like a 2-hour heads-up match. 1.5 hours or some shit. Let's go. Let's fucking go. Fuck yeah. Fuck yeah. What a fucking grind, guys. Whew. Good day so far. Third and fourth in the hyper for 600. Now ship this one for 1400. Be back. Let's quickly see how much we actually won. 854.37 plus 624.38. 1,478 bucks and 75 cents. Not bad. Not bad, everyone. G fucking G. What a fucking battle. What a fucking battle.